Hi guys, I'm Sarah Quinn, and I am an admin on the UK Vape Community Facebook group. I just thought I'd drop that in there just in case you're some person who's just randomly found this on YouTube and you're not from our group. We often get asked, well, we get asked lots of questions all the time on the Facebook group about various different things. One of the most common questions is along the lines of, oh, I've just bought a K-Fun or I've just bought a dripper and I need to make my first ever coil. How many wraps do I need to make a 1.2 ohm coil, say, for example? And we always point them in the direction of this website. This website is called Steam Engine, okay? I'll put a link for it in the comments so that you can find it nice and easy. The site also does other things, Ohm's Law, battery drain, e-liquid calculator, as you can see, but I'm using it specifically today for Steam Engine. Now, when it first comes up, it can be quite confusing. If you've never made a coil before, you look at this and you see all these boxes and you think, oh my God, what am I going to put in there? What does it all mean? So I'm just going to do a very basic tutorial today on just how to use this. Right, I'm not going to touch on battery safety, on all that kind of Ohm's Law and all that stuff. Please don't start building coils until you have done your research on these things, okay? On this channel, on our community channel, we've put together a playlist for you, tutorials on vaping equipment, coiling, etc., by us and others, okay? And in here there are plenty of tutorials. Please do watch them. I cannot reiterate enough about battery safety, knowing what your mod goes down to, what it will fire to, what is safe for your battery, etc. All right, any questions, go over to the Facebook group and ask, but do your research. It's all very, there's so much information out there. I would also highly recommend, say if, for example, you've just bought your first ever K-Fun or Orchid or whatever it is, or Plume Veil, or I'm mentioning these things because they're things that we own. So research that. Have a look on YouTube and find somebody who has made a build for that particular RDA or RBA, okay? Because they will have probably played around an awful lot and found the best setup that works, and they'll talk you through exactly what is what. But to use this, say for example you've just suddenly got your new tank and you decide that you want a single coil it or dual coil it, this is the program that will tell you how many wraps you need to make that coil. Okay, now we'll go through the basics here. First off, we have, well, you have metric or imperial. I always work in metric, as I'm sure most people will. Now, material and profile. So up here is your standard Canthal. Most people, this is what you'll be using. If, however, you choose to use nichrome, or you can change it in here. Otherwise, just leave it alone, and it is round. But you do get ribbon Canthal, so you have the option here to change that. So that's standard. Now, you have AWG and millimetres. Now, a lot of people seem to get confused about this. Just want to quickly point it out. A lot of people you'll see that will say, oh, I have 0.28. And what they actually mean is they have 28 gauge, 28 AWG. Now, if you look on this little chart here, 28 is actually 0.32. Okay, now it's important to point that out, because if you're looking at other people and they're saying, oh, 0.28, and you're thinking, oh, that's 28 gauge, it's not, all right? This little diagram is on the group in the file section. Now, 28 gauge is standard, is 0.32, okay? Now, we buy from Wire and Stuff, and we buy 0.3, which technically, it's advertised as 28 gauge, but technically speaking, it's not really. It's between 29 and 28, but it's fractions of millimetres, so, you know, it's not going to make a huge difference unless you're sub-owning and you're really going for points and what have you. I would recommend usually around 28 gauge, 0.32 for a tank, a standard, and for my dripper, I personally use 26, which is 0.4, but some people use 24 gauge, which is 0.51. Reason for that, thicker wire, so when you're dripping, you're actually going to create more vapor, more surface area and all of that. Okay, again, I'm not going to go into the technicals of this. This is a real beginner's guide to just using this program, but just a couple of things needed to be pointed out there, all right? So in here, I would put 0.3 because that is the wire that I have. However, you could do it over here on the AWG and say put 28 gauge in, and that will automatically change there. You see, 28 gauge is actually 0.321. All right. It's up to you, whichever way you're doing it. But I do it with the millimeters. I have 0.3 wire. And a single coil. Okay. So if I was to make a single coil and I wanted to make my single coil at 1.2 ohms, this will do calculate everything for me over here. However, I have an orchid, and it's something I really need to touch on again very quickly. I'm not going to go into the ins and outs of this. There is lots of information out there. There's lots of information on YouTube itself. In fact, I looked at one just a minute ago. If you are doing a dual coil, it halves your resistance. If I wanted to make a 1 ohm coil, all right, but I was going to dual, as you can see here, I haven't touched up here yet, so just ignore that for a second. But for example, if I wanted a single coil at 1 ohm, it says I need 7 wraps. Watch what happens if I change that to dual. So I'm going to put 2 coils in. Now, as you can see, all of a sudden, 15 wraps, okay? It is halved. It is literally, because you suddenly, instead of having to pump through just one wire, you're going through 2 wires. So to make a 1 ohm, if I wanted a resistance of 1 ohm and I was doing 2 coils, I'd have to make 2 coils at 2 ohms to bring it to 1 ohm. It's confusing. Do your research, all right? But I just wanted to point that out. But let's just go for our basic single coil. This is the beauty of this program, however. You know, as long as you know the basic concepts, it's going to tell you what you need to do anyway, all right? It's going to tell you exactly what you need to do. So I've got a 0.3 wire. I want to make 1 coil, just the one, and I want it to be 1.2 ohms, okay? Up here is your diameter of your coil. Now, that is what you are going to wrap it around. Now, a lot of people use the little blue screwdrivers that come with their Fast Tech orders or other orders, yeah? And they are around 2 millimeters. So if you're using a little screwdriver, then you'd just put 2 mil in there. If you're using one of these jigs, a lot of the jigs have slightly different measurements. We do, and ours, I usually use the 2.4 mil. All right. If I'm doing a dripper, then I'll use a 3.2 millimeter. It's fatter. That gives me more surface area again, so I can produce more vapor and clouds. It also gives me more room for more wick, so I'm not having to drip so continuously, because obviously there's more wick to soak up more juice. I can put more juice in there. But for a tank, I would normally use 2.4. That's the inside of the coil where you're going to be putting your wick. And the leg length, this is just literally, as it says here, total length of resistance wires between coil and contact points. So where your coil is positioned going in to your post holes. Now, I personally leave this at 5 millimeter. If you think you're doing 4 millimeter leg length, then you can change it. It does make a difference. Not the biggest of difference though, okay? It's not really gonna, as you can see, as I change this, the numbers are changing over here, but really not an awful lot, all right? And then voila, that's it over here, number of wraps. So if I want to make a 1.2 ohm single coil and I'm using approximately 28 gauge, 0.3 wire, okay? And I'm using, this is the important one here, this does change things a lot. If I was to change this to 3.5, you'll notice I would only need 4 wraps, but 2.4 diameter, I need, now, what do I do? 5.67 wraps, so this is up to you. You can either round this up or you can round this down. You could do 6 wraps or you could do 5 wraps. 5 wraps is going to lower this a bit, so if you're, say, using a VAMO, you might be needing it to definitely fire, say, above 1.1 ohm, I would actually round it up to 6 wraps. If you're doing 2 coils, remember, you're going to need to double it. See, you're going to need to do 11 wraps on one coil and 11 wraps on the other coil as well. 2 wraps. It does very clearly say here, okay? And that's it. Job done. All that remains is for you to check it. Please do check it before you use it. All right, I keep on about this safety. There's enough bad press for vaping at the moment, batteries blowing up, etc. And it's because people aren't doing the research. Shops are to fault as well for not, you know, giving their customers enough knowledge. But if you're buying off of the internet and that, a lot of this stuff comes and it doesn't come with instruction manuals. So please do research. You can't just stick any old charger into a battery. And I'm sorry, but this morning we saw some more press, another news story about somebody had used the wrong charger and his battery had blown up and destroyed most of their house and belongings just before Christmas, which is very sad. But you know, it's using incorrect equipment. So get yourself an ohms reader or variable wattage device, something like the Vamo or Hannah does a perfect job. It will check it. It will tell you what your ohms are, whether you've got it right, whether you're close, whether you're not close, and whether it's shorting. If it's not working, it won't fire. So it's the safest way of doing it. Don't just build it and stick it on a mech mod. All right, check it first. And then if you are on our vape community group, the UK Vape Community Facebook group, and you have used this and made your first build, do us a video and give us a look. Yeah? All right. Thanks ever so much. Bye bye.